Are you afraid of data structures and algorithms? Do you feel low confidence while dealing with DSA? Are you confused how to learn DSA? Then this video is for you. So we are going to cover psychology, tips, strategy, process, resources on learning DSA so that no one can challenge you. In today's world, everything is data. Image is a data. Video is a data. Browsing e-commerce website is dealing with data. Ordering food online is dealing with data. And these companies store data in exabyte, and 1 exabyte is 1 billion gigabytes. So these companies require to store more and more data with less and less storage. So they want to process more and more data with less and less time. So space and time is coming into picture, and that's where DSA also comes into a picture, because DSA deals with space and time. And that's why for every problem we hear terms like, what is the space complexity of this problem? What is the time complexity of this problem? Practically, we do not use DSA to get the shortest of 5 different integers, right? That is just for practice purpose. Actually, if you see the e-commerce website, they have millions of orders every day. They handle millions of users every day. Google has billions of searches every day. If you take example of ATC, air traffic controller, they manage hundreds and thousands of flights in a day. Even a 1 second of delay can cause a huge loss to business and a huge loss to human life. So that's why all technical companies focus a lot on data structures and algorithms. I have covered this in more detailed way in a separate video. Please watch out that video. So this is one of my favorite points in this video, and if you understand this point, your 50% of the problem will be solved. The only reason companies focus a lot on data structures and algorithms in interview is to evaluate your critical thinking ability, your optimal thinking ability, and we want this critical thinking skill or optimal thinking skill as a habit. So whenever you are approaching a problem, okay, it may not be always a programming problem, right? It can be a database design, it can be a front-end design. We want that, okay, you have to approach optimally. And this habit cannot be developed in 1 month of time or 3 months of time. It needs 6 months to 1 year of time. And that's where folks make mistake, right? They take DSA as a regular subject, which can be finished in 3 months of time. So DSA is not a regular subject that you can start and finish in 3 months of time. So it will take time, it will take patience, it will take practice. So it's same like playing chess. So chess is played as a sport also, and chess is played as a habit to develop your critical thinking skills. So this habit can be developed in DSA by practicing 100 questions or by practicing 500 questions. It depends upon individual's capability. So don't focus on number of questions, focus on developing this critical thinking habit. I will tell you one more interesting point. It may be surprising for many of you. After 8 to 10 years of experience in any IT company, you are not going to write code. It will be very minimum code you are going to write, or it will be no code at all. So if you take DSA as a skill of programming or coding, so it will be of no use after 8 to 10 years of your IT experience, because you are not going to code at all. But if you take this as a habit of critical thinking and optimal thinking, this skill is going to help you in your entire IT career. So initially you will be solving around 1 question or 2 questions out of every 10 questions. So with time it will go to 2 to 3 questions, and then 4 to 5 questions. If you are able to solve 50 to 60% of question optimally, a medium complexity problem without any external help, I think then you got a good understanding of data structures and algorithms. So after that you have to just keep practicing and make it to 50, 60 or 70% of problem that you can solve optimally without any help. Don't try to achieve 100%, it's not possible. Just to conclude this point, whenever you are approaching any problem, think from all direction, okay? Spend some good amount of time. It's okay even if you're not able to solve that, okay? That will be your learning. So let's suppose if you're not able to solve it by thinking in all direction, okay, check the solution. That will be your learning. And whenever you are approaching your next question, try to utilize these learnings in your next question. So this is how with every question you practice, your critical thinking ability will improve. Accept that DSA is a time-taking skill, and you need 4 things. You need patience and practice and practice. Most people are afraid of DSA because they heard it is tough, or they are not able to solve optimally their initial 10 questions. Yes, for a non-swimmer to swim in one go, it's tough. But is it tough for a well-practiced swimmer to swim? Similarly, in DSA, like in your first week, in your first month, in your first 50 questions, there will be a lot of struggle. There will be no success. But if you practice this consistently for 3 to 6 months of time, you will see a huge difference. So start small, start easy, and gradually increase your complexity. And in 6 months of time, you will see a huge difference and you will stop complaining about DSA and start sailing with DSA. So let's talk about some recommended resources. We are going to cover books, we are going to cover video lecture series, and we are going to cover some online platforms also. So I have read this book, Data Structures and Algorithms Made Easy by Career Monk Publication, and the author is Narasimha Karumanchi. I personally read this when I was in college, and I have used as a handbook while switching jobs, like after college also. This book is easy to understand, easy to visualize. So it's not that this is the only option. There are multiple articles written which recommends like best books for learning DSA. I will link them in description. So I will suggest to complete end to end one book, and only one book, not more than one nor less than one. The book that I have mentioned is also present in these articles. 0 to 1 is a top rated course in Udemy. Udacity's DSA course is also recommended, and there are some NPTEL lectures also available. So link of all these courses will be available in the description. And one point to note here, that no book or no lecture series is foolproof in itself. There are many topics which are brilliantly explained in these books or lecture series, and many topics you will get that is not that well explained. So there are multiple articles written, multiple content creators on YouTube who have created brilliant content on these different topics. So as and when, if you're getting any topic which is not that good explained by a book or lecture series, you can watch this, you can read more about this and get your doubt clarified. So personally, I haven't followed any lecture series on DSA, but I did some research, read about ratings, learned about the instructor and the syllabus. And from that experience, these courses are my top picks. So I have followed Career Monk publication book, like Data Structures and Algorithms Made Easy by Narasimha Karumanchi, and I jumped directly into online platforms. So goal of book or lecture series is to like have fundamental concepts clear on data structures and algorithms. You know, like art of approaching a problem optimally, and you are able to practice easy to medium complexity problem. So if you are confident on these all things via book or lecture series, then any one is fine. So whichever you are choosing, please finish it end to end and don't make a mistake of leaving in midway. So once you are fundamentally strong from book or lecture series, now it's the practice part, and this is the continuous process. There are many platforms available, like LeetCode is one leading platform, HackerRank is another good platform, Geeks for Geeks is also a good platform. So all these platforms has like libraries of questions. The question is topic wise listed, company wise listed, difficulty wise listed. So you can start with easy, gradually move to medium and hard complexity problems. For every question you approach, you have to follow a consistent process, and I will tell you like what is the benefit of this consistent process at the end of this point. So here's my like 5-step process of approaching any problem. Step number one, analyze with multiple examples. So whenever you are getting a problem, take some like a small size example, a medium size example, and a little large size example. Like what is the input and what is the output? You should have complete clarity of like what is the ask. So one example that is given in your question may not give you a complete clarity. Step number two, solve on paper first. Okay, so write the pseudo code, not the actual code, on the paper first. Step number three, think like pictures. So whichever problem which can be depicted pictorially, then think like pictures, especially non-linear data structure like graphs, trees, even linked list. So these can be depicted easily in pictures. So it is easy to visualize, it is easy to grasp, it is easy to understand. Step number four, dry runs. With the examples that we have taken in our first step, try run your pseudocode and improvise. Okay, take care of edge cases, and in interviews especially focus on these edge cases that an invalid input is passed to your method. What is the output? Is all corner case handled or not? Step number 5, the final step, is write on the system. So there's a term called production ready code. So you have to write a code which can be deployed directly into a live environment. So your code should be that robust and error free. So folks make a mistake that they directly jump into the solution part of any problem. So what happens in interviews, like if people are not able to solve their problem in initial 5 to 10 minutes of time, they are getting anxiety. And whenever you are anxious, you are not able to utilize your 100% of capability. So this process is going to like help you to control the anxiety. And whenever you follow the process while practicing also, so it will become a habit. So whenever in your interview experiences or like in your competitions, like whenever you approach a problem, you have to follow this step by step process so that it will control your anxiety. I have seen people that are getting rejected because of anxiety. I know that they can solve it, but because of anxiety, they are not able to express it. They are not able to communicate it properly, and which leads in rejection. While practicing, make it a habit that you have to write the code. Even if you are not getting the logic, write the simplest logic, the brute force approach, but write that code and start optimizing from there. Even if you are not getting the brute force approach, let's suppose, check the solution, understand it, but write the code and make it as a habit that in your initial 100 question, you have to write the code, no matter you know the logic, you are able to solve optimally or not, but write the code. Tip number 2, DSA is different, programming is different. So before you approach a DSA problem, you should have a good command, a fundamental command on any one programming language. You should know like what is loops, recursion, conditional logic, if else statement. And I have created a separate video on like tips of learning programming. Please watch out that video. Tip number 3, learn from every question you practice. So think from all directions. If you're approaching a problem, spend some good amount of time. Think from all directions. Even if you're not able to solve it, that's your learning. And note that down in your notebook or notepad and utilize these learnings in your next questions. And if you practice it seriously, like in next 50 to 100 questions, you'll see that many questions you are able to solve from these learnings only. And this learning is going to make you a different from other persons. Tip number 4, keep revising your tips and learnings. So sometimes you will get a tip like how to traverse a data structure in a better way. Sometimes you will get a tip of like how to store in a better way. Sometimes you will get a tip on like how to approach a problem from some new direction. Okay, so if you keep revising these tips and utilizing these tips in your questions, okay, so many times you will see that you are able to get a more optimized solution than what is available online. Tip number 5, black box thinking. So assume that your program need searching, sorting, and some standard set of algorithms. Standard algorithms are available as libraries. Okay, so you don't have to think on sorting, searching, or any standard algorithm. Okay, think on your actual logic rather on these standard algorithms. Tip number 6, your first 100 question will be a struggle, but after that you will enjoy this journey. Tip number 7, don't go to contest till your fundamentals are not clear and you haven't solved at least 100 or 150 questions of medium complexity. Contest has complex problems and it needs confidence and good practice before even you attempt it. And you have to practice according to your goal. So if your goal is like job, prepare for interview experience questions. If your goal is competition, prepare similar questions. Tip number 8, don't try to memorize. It is not going to help in any way. Practice is the only key. Tip number 9, so from my understanding, if you are able to solve 50 to 60% of problem of medium complexity optimally without any external help, I think you have excellent understanding of DSA. So don't try too much perfection, which is not possible in case of DSA. Our last tip, and this tip I have repeated in multiple videos, that don't just focus on DSA. DSA is one of the important subjects of computer science, but there are other fundamental subjects like database management system, operating system, computer networks, okay, which are equally important. Okay, so focus on those subjects also. to become a robust computer science engineer, you need strong command on all these fundamental subjects. So I have given all points on like why part, the psychology, resources, tips, process that I have personally utilized to become, have a strong command on data structures and algorithms. Like, please let me know in comments what is stopping you in becoming pro in data structures and algorithms. And I'm going to cover those in my next videos. And at the end, I just want to say that DSA is patience, practice, consistency, learning, and repeat. Thank you.